Church of St. Vincent de Paul, as today we celebrate the Epiphany of our Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship and communion of God's Spirit be always with you.
Amen.
My friends, living in an age well before the internet and social media, the Magi from the East relied upon a single star as a sign that a king had been born. The heavens revealed to these learned astrologers that a matter of great import had occurred in Judea. Today we celebrate the revelation of that birth, the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ to the outside world, to us. The light over the little town of Bethlehem has revealed the light of the world to the ends of the earth. For the times we have not allowed that light into our lives, may we ask the Lord for his pardon. Lord Jesus, you scattered the darkness of sin and death. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you announced the good news of salvation to all. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring justice and mercy to the world. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and may he bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
pass through the shadows of this world and reach the brightness of our eternal home through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who gathers us here in the Holy Spirit to be one with one another and one with you, our God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of the nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you, dromedaries from Midian and Ephah. All from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, You have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Will the vaccine do what we hope it will? Will this end the virus or perhaps even spread it? And the pandemic is not the only darkness that's in our world. There's racism, economic disparity, terrorism in Nigeria, Kenya, and Ethiopia. There are millions and millions of refugees and migrants. And maybe one question that I'm asking myself, and maybe you can ask yourselves the same, is when will peace reign in our hearts? I don't think it's a question that should not be asked. Why? Because Isaiah and the Magi remind us of the peace that the Lord has promised. We hear it in the scriptures. We hear it proclaimed on television. And so we ask ourselves, when will things get better? Will they get better immediately? Obviously not, because they would have been better by now. The Magi represent those of us following the God-provided light. I don't know how many of you saw the star that they call the Bethlehem Star in the sky the other day. If you missed it, that's your chance, because it's not coming around for another 800 some years. That star presumably shined on the people who were called the insiders, and it also shone for the outsiders as well. A path has been illuminated. A way has been shown us, and I think that we have to live by the light that was given us by the Lord. We pray at this Eucharist, or maybe we pray better at home or online, and we pray for clear minds, courageous hearts, and the perseverance to stay on the path that Jesus has given us. Because he manifested to us the path of forgiveness, reconciliation, and peace. If it's his path we follow, we too will shine some light on the darkness of people whose lives have been hampered by it. And perhaps we can be guides to the people as well, to help them find their way home or to a land and a people of light bearers. You really have to look at the readings today, because there might be some details in there that unless we were really keen, we might have missed them. Did you notice that the Magi did not unload their camels? They didn't dismiss their porters, and they didn't settle down in Bethlehem to continue their homage to the Christ child. Matthew makes it sound as if they did homage to the child, quickly got up off their knees, and then moved on. Maybe they went home to tell their families. Maybe they went home to tell about that star that guided them. A star that appears very infrequently. You know as well as I do that the stars are always there. It's just that we can't see them in daylight. Maybe we shouldn't be terrified of darkness in our lives. You know what? From the earliest ages when we begin to comprehend what life is all about, we're afraid of the dark. How many of us were afraid of the dark years and years and centuries ago? How many of us wanted a nightlight on? How many times did we check under the bed before we fell asleep? And if you didn't, I guarantee your kids did. Maybe we shouldn't be afraid of the darkness, because God had taken care of it once before when he created the light of the moon and the sun. You know, these stories that we've heard the past couple of days have all been told by people who experienced angelic visitations. We heard about pregnancy and birth. But I think St. Matthew is proposing a fuller gospel account to us than did Luke. The God of salvation is acting on our behalf, and we are invited to respond with lives transformed by God's love in us. Already there's hints of both acceptance and rejection of the newborn King of the Jews. Epiphany is not the end of the story. It's just the beginning for us. It's the time when Christ was manifest or shown to the world. What difference will what is manifested to us today make in our lives tomorrow? Is the Epiphany that we celebrate tonight going to make a difference tomorrow, or Monday, or Tuesday? Or is it even going to make a difference when we get home tonight? Throughout the church's year, from the first Sunday of Advent until the feast of Christ the King, we will hear Jesus preaching, we will observe his works, follow him to his death, and then experience his resurrection. It will be a year, hopefully, of many epiphanies for us. As we leave church today, not right now, but when I'm done, and we leave the Christmas scene, we have confidence that no darkness we face can put out the light that we have achieved with the message of the life of Jesus Christ. Hear again what Isaiah the prophet said. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. Wouldn't it be great if we could all resolve to continually focus ourselves on the light that we have seen? Wouldn't it be great if we could bow down and worship and then carry that light into the world? Because you know that's what we are called to do. The Magi's quest reminds us that throughout our lives, we are continually searching for God. And if we claim that we found God and everything there is to know about him, we're fibbing. Because we just can't know everything there is to know about God. If we did, he wouldn't be God. We can never settle back into complacency. And even though we think that we have found God, there's more up ahead. So we have to pack up and keep searching and searching. We also have to be mindful of the journey of other people, because we all don't journey at the same pace or at the same time. Other people's journeys may differ than ours, and they probably do. The truth is too big for any of us to claim to have it all. God can't be grasped totally in our hands, no matter how big they are. And so, as we kneel and do the Prince of Peace homage, may we remember that he has come to show us his love, his care, his peace, and his forgiveness to all of us. It's not limited to one nation. It's not limited to one culture. It may not even be limited to one religion. For God has come to show his people his love. And as you know, love can take many forms. Thank you, and God bless you. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Before we bring our gifts to the altar in homage, let us with trust and confidence offer prayer for our sister and brother human beings. And our response will be, Child of Mary, hear us.
That God's holy people may lovingly invite all to come and be heirs with us as members of one body of Christ, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That hearts may be transformed from hatred to love, so that all nations may walk in God's light, free from war and violence, and all rulers pay him homage, serving him in justice and peace, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That in this new year, our government leaders may bring renewed hope to the many who are unemployed, food insecure, homeless, or threatened with homelessness, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That winter's dark and cold may move us to rededicate ourselves to warming in whatever way we can, the hurting of our family and neighbors, near and far, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That the vaccination process may proceed in every state as orderly and peacefully as possible, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That our Catholic Christian communities may offer Christ Jesus the gold of a living faith, the incense of beautiful worship, and the myrrh of compassion for others, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That our servicemen and women, our first responders, and our medical personnel and essential workers may be covered with safety, and the seriously ill in our parish community and among our family members and friends, gifted with love's confidence and the healing touch of our God, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us.
That Easter's glorious promise may wrap the hearts of those among us in mourning, and for our mass intentions, all parishioners of St. Vincent's, all our beloved dead, come to the everlasting embrace of God's peace and love, we pray.
Child of Mary, hear us. Gracious God, with deep gratitude, we thank you for revealing your loving kindness through the person of Jesus. Bless this gathering of your church with your Spirit, that we may, in loving kindness, reveal him to others. This we pray as all things, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
friends, pray that my sacrifice and yours will be accepted by God, our Almighty Father.
May you always accept the sacrifice of your hands and praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of the Holy Spirit.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, our offerings in honor of the appearing of your only begotten Son and the first fruits of the nations, that to you praise may be rendered and eternal salvation be ours, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Father,
Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious cup in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the cup to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for many, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the many gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the cup of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones who are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar may receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and sleep in the rest of peace. And sleep. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a light of refreshment, light of peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Protect us from anxiety and distress and sin and whatever may lead us to sin. so that we may wait as a joyful people in hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Do not look upon our sins and failings, but rather on our faith and the faith of your church. And graciously grant to us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be always with you.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of the Lord's peace. Let us pray. renewed by the sacred nourishment, we implore your mercy, Lord, that the star of your justice may shine always bright in our minds, and that our true treasure may ever consist in our confession of you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who has called us out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon us, and make our hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity. Amen. Amen. And since in all confidence we follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make us too a light for our sisters and brothers.
Amen. Amen.
And so when our pilgrimage is ended, may we come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon us, and may it remain with us forever.
Amen.
As God's people, let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other.
Thanks be to God.
You have a good evening.
Thanks be to God.